State governorship candidate of the African Democratic Congress, ADC, Prince Gboyega Nasir Isiaka GNI, has promised to reinstate the chairman of the Nigerian Labour Congress, NLC, Comrade Akeem Ambali. Another Labour leader sacked by the incumbent, Ibikunle Amosun, if elected in 2019. Recall that Amosun had in 2016 dismissed the NLC chairman alongside his vice, Comrade Dare Ilekoya, and others over alleged misconduct. Isiaka, who described the sack as an abuse of office, also promised to create a conducive environment for the state's labor force to thrive. The ADC governorship candidates gave the assurance during a consultative meeting with executive members of the NLC, led by Akeem Ambali in Abeokuta, the Ogun State capital.
Just like we're here, Governor Ibikunle Amosun then came to NLC. Remember, he came twice. He was dancing both Bata and Ambala. We welcome him. We pray for him. He emerged as the governor. The NLC chairman lost his job. Ever do. You are here. You captured your mission. Beautiful manner. Our interest is about workers' welfare. One. Number two, rural development in Ogun State. Rural development. In third world, emphasis now is on rural transformation to prevent drifting to urban centers because of heavy pollution. Heavy crime, poor sanitation, and so many other reasons. The greenest environment is in the rural area. What are they like? Rural roads, good health, educational infrastructure, mobilization, and encouragement of architects. Creating a social welfare scheme, sir, is unfortunate. Our social welfare policy in Nigeria and Ogun State can see conglomerate of companies springing up in the rural areas without having a direct benefit and impact on the rural areas where they exist. My campaign objective and my campaign slogan is centered around what we call Greater Ogun State. Greater Ogun State. And that is what we center all of the things, or most of the things that we are doing. That's what we center it around. So if there is anything that we are talking about, the issue is that how does it contribute to us having a greater state? And it is start by us saying that we do not want to begin to unnecessarily, oh yes, constructively, we will not have insurance, but to look at policies and approaches of past administration. At some point in the campaign. But on the whole idea is not about who has done what or who has not done what. The important thing that we believe is that all of the people that have had opportunities to govern our state have contributed in their own ways. Because of what we have gone past in the past, and as the chairman also mentioned it, somebody was there 8 years ago dancing Bata and dancing Fuji. So it is only natural for us to, you know, believe or have doubt. I want to assure you that my candidacy, aside from all of these that I've mentioned, my candidacy also centers around sincerity of purpose. And one of the things I have also said is that what makes a good government, a good governor and a bad governor, is not only what you know or your experience, it's about also the kind of person that you are. Who I am, you know, because we've been together for upward of 12, 13 years. And therefore, you have a fair idea. Yes, there's a tendency that when you get to office, the office may treat you somehow. But fact of the matter is that there is nobody that is as close to you as I am. First. Secondly, my records are clean. My records are open. There is nothing about my history. There is nothing about my history, about my life history that is not everywhere on the internet. So I come to this government by the grace of God with integrity. And I think it is that same thing that I want to use to run a government. I give God the glory. If I have been able to run this state, particularly against an incumbent that have access to my records while I was in office, and yet I haven't got to run against him in a highly competitive context, I think it also says a few things about me. Not only that, I also have the blood to come and run again. I think it says a few things about me. And no matter what anybody will say about me, because I do my editorial with me, but I think that what people are likely to say is that he still has a fair level of homology. And that is what we want to do.
And finally, restatement of Comrade Akin Ambali and other supervised members of NLC TDC that were unduly and illegally dismissed. These things are things that we have written down after a thorough research, and indeed I have a signed letter here. Beyond being on tape, I have a signed letter here that actually mentioned all of this. And it is my pleasure to present the letter to you.